Why do Americans spell and say aluminium as aluminum? Is aluminum incorrect? Who's right, the British or Americans? Should it be called aluminium or aluminum? And is it okay to use the suffix -um instead of -ium in the first place? This causes a lot of debates. I know that British folks love to tell us Americans how we get words wrong and how dumb we are. I understand, but we aren't so dumb as you think we are. We're just stubborn. The person who discovers an element gets to name it. The discoverer of the element aluminium or aluminum was Sir Humphrey Davy. To be clear, Davy just discovered the presence of the element in a base that was already known to the ancient Greeks and which had been named alum. The element wasn't isolated until later in 1825. Davy at first was undecided on which to call it. He first named it aluminium. Then a bit later, he decided to call it aluminum. Then he later changed it back to aluminium. Hey, he gets to name it. And he finally did decide on aluminium, so that's the name, right? Well, sure. But once he first changed the name to aluminum, a number of trade magazines in the US adopted this name. So perhaps due to editorial decisions and perhaps the choices of aluminum trading companies, who for whatever reason like aluminum better than aluminium, the name stuck in America. The scientific world and other countries besides America used aluminium. So that's pretty much why we call it aluminum in America. But some people say that we Americans are so dumb that we don't even realize that the suffix -um is incorrect. Well, tell that to Sir Humphrey Davy. And also, tell it to the Romans. You know those Latin-speaking people, the ones who came up with all this -um and -ium stuff? The fact is, there are other elements that do use the suffix -um instead of -ium. Molybdenum, tantalum, platinum, and lanthanum. And the Romans had -um names for some of our more familiar metals. Plumbum for lead, stannum for tin, ferrum for iron, etc. This is where we get the abbreviations for them, like SN for stannum or tin, and PB for plumbum or lead. Seems like the Romans themselves had no problem with Unless you look very deeply, which I doubt most people will want to do, you will find little logical consistency in the way elements are named. What we can see is that -ium has been pretty much decided on as the de facto suffix for elements named in the 19th century. This would mean that aluminium was more consistent with that naming pattern. But this -ium decision also breaks earlier naming patterns, such as naming noble gases with an -on. Helium is a noble gas, but it's not called helon. Then we have oxygen and nitrogen. It gets really confusing, and the particular reasons for the different naming patterns, while I did begin to research them, quite frankly, they bored me, so I suspected they bore you too. But let's just agree that aluminium and aluminum both have a right to exist, and it's easier to say aluminum foil than aluminium foil. I'm just saying. Maybe that's why some British folks still carry on with tin foil, even though it's not made of tin anymore. Who's dumb now? No, I'm kidding. I'll admit that my mom and my grandmother used to call aluminum foil tin foil too. And some folks in America still do. And we still say tin foil hat even though you would make one out of aluminum. But here's the thing. The word aluminium just sounds very strange to our American ears. You can't convince us aluminium sounds right any more than we can convince you that aluminum sounds right. So let's just all agree that aluminum foil is much better than tin foil. And it is way better.